Hello students of class 8. So today I'm going to start the next topic, and the next topic is square root by division method. The last method was not discussed in my previous lecture, so I'm going to discuss that topic and the remaining topic of chapter 3. Okay, so today I'm going to finish this chapter, so try to follow me. See here, you have to find the square root by division method. So already I have discussed about the square root. So what is division method? See, you have to divide, but there is a rule for division. Like in simple divisions, we divide randomly, okay? We divide by any number, but here there are some rules. You have to follow the rules, you have to follow the steps. So see, I have taken one example, 4225, okay? So this number I am going to find the square root of this number. So how to find? See, first of all, you have to write in this way. You have to write the number, that is 4225. Then you have to make a line like this above this, and then next you have to make a line, okay, vertically like this. After that, what you have to do? You have to pair the numbers from the back side. So you have to start from back side. So pair the numbers. So 25. First pair is 25 from back side, so make a bar above this number, above this pair. Next is 42, again make a bar above this number, okay. Next what you have to do, next you have to check the first number from the first side, from the front side. What is the first pair? That is 42. So you have to find a square number which is less than 42 or equal to 42. But as you see, 42 is not a square number, so you have to take a number which is less than 42, and you have to take a square number. So for example, 5 5s are 25. Already you know about square number, okay? So here I have to take what? 6, because 6 6 is 36. So 6 6 are, we have to write 36 below the first pair, okay? Now I am going to subtract it. So after subtraction, I will get what? 6. 12 minus 6 is 6. So now you have to take 25 below. So 25. See, in normal division, we have to take one by one. One digit will come only at once. Okay. But here you have to take two digits. You have to take the pair. Okay. If one comes, then the other also comes, because they are in pairs. You have to take pairs. So here, what is the number? 625. Now, in division, what happened? Your divisor, that is the number you are dividing with, the number remains same in division, in normal division. But here, your divisor, every time your divisor will change, your divisor will change, okay? So what you have to do? You have to double 6. So what is the double of 6? Double of 6 is 12. So you have to write here 12. Okay, that's why I have drawn one line like this. You have to draw one line horizontally like this, okay? So you have to double the 6. What is the double of 6? That is 12. Okay, so next, here you have to leave one space for one digit, okay? So what number you can write means, again you have to take a square number. Suppose 5 5 5s are 25, okay? Like that you have to take a square number. So next, if I take 3, see here, 1 2 and I have taken what? 3. Then I have to multiply 123 with 3, because you have to take again a square number. Like in first case, what we have done, we have taken a square number. In the similar way, here you have to take a square number, but you have to include 12 in your divisor. In your new divisor, you have to include 12 also. So 1, 2, 3. 3 3s are, it will become 9. See, in 1's place it is 9. But in 1's place, you should get what? 5. Already you know, when we get 5, when we multiply it with 5. That means 5 5s are 25, okay? So in place of this 1's place, means where I have written 3, we have to write 5. So 125 5s are, you have to see 125 5s are, okay? So 5 5s are 25. So it will become 12, 2 carrying 1, so it will come as 625. So you have to write 5 here, then again 5 here, so 625. So remainder is what? 0. So what is the square root of 4225? It is 65. So this is the division method. You have to follow division method. See, this method is applicable for a square number also and for a non-square number. Means if a number is not a square number, then also you can find the square root of that number. Okay. So we can write square root of 4225 is 65. Okay. So next, come to the next topic. Next topic is square root of rational number. In square root of rational number, already you know rational number is in p by q form. Always it is in p by q form, provided denominator not equal to 0. So when you have to find the square root of a rational number, you have to find the square root of numerator as well as the square root of denominator. Both you have to find. Okay. So if there is a number, suppose root over 4 by 9. Okay, what you have to do? Root over 4 by 9. Then you can do what? You can find root over 4 by root over 9. Okay, you have to find individually the square root of numerator and denominator. So square root of 4, you know, it will come as 2, and 9, it will come as 3. So square root of 4 by 9, you can say the answer is 2 by. So our next topic is square root of decimal numbers, and there are two topics under this. First is the number which is a perfect square. Okay, so I am going to discuss in the exercise question only. Next, under this we have another topic, that is square root of numbers which are not perfect square, correct up to two decimal places. That means after decimal place there will be two digits present. Okay, if there are three digits, then you have to round off and you have to write the two digits up to after decimal point. This is the meaning of correct up to two decimal places. So these two topics I am going to discuss in the exercise, in exercise 3.4 only. Okay, so next come to the estimation. So what is estimation? See, we can find the square root of any number without actual calculation. Means actual calculation means we cannot apply any method. We will directly estimate. Okay, for example, if any number is given, you have to check that square number. That square number is between which two square numbers. Okay, like in estimation, we will not apply any particular formula. Before, when you have done in class 5, class 6, whenever you are doing estimation question, then we are not applying any formula. There is no particular formula for estimation. Just you have to estimate, you have to approximate. Means if, for example, if there is a number 251, so 251 you have to check 251 is the square of which number. Means what is the square root of 251 you have to find. So for that you have to go to the closest square number of 251. As you can see, 251 is not a square number, so you have to go to the nearest number of 251. Okay, so nearest number of 251, nearest square number of 251 is 256. So like that you have to write the estimation value. So this topic also I am going to discuss in exercise 3.4. So let us do it. So the question number 1 in exercise 3.4 is finding the square root of the following number by division method. So this is the division method, already we have done it. So I'm not going to do it again. So try to do it, exercise 3.4, question number 1. And if you find any difficulty, please ask me. So come to question number 2. So we will start from question number 2. Find the square root of following. So question number 2, 7. So you have to find the root of 1024 divided by 2401. So you can do it by any method, because here they have not mentioned the method. So I am doing it using prime factorization method. So First of all, you have to find the factor of numerator, then denominator. So after factorization, I got the number of 2 as 10 in numerator and in denominator. When we multiply 7 4 times, we will get 2 4 0 1. So here you have to pair and you have to take out the numbers. So 7 into 7 in denominator and in numerator, again pair. So by pairing, we got 1 2 2 3 4 5. So there are 5 number of 2s. So that means 2 to the power 5. So 2 to the power 5 will be what? 32 by 7 square, that is 49. So square root of 1024 by 2401 is what? 32 by 49. So come to question number 3. Here you have to find the square root of decimal number. So take, so we will take question number 6. Okay, I am going to do question number 6. So see this question. So here we are dividing 8136.04 by 9 first. So our first divisor is 9. So first of all, what you have to do? You have to make this, okay? You have to make this line first, then you have to write the number, and then from back side you have to make pairs. So 04 is first pair, 36 is second, so then 81 is the third pair. So from front side, we have the first pair as 81. So you have to see that 81 is a square number. So the square root of 81 is 9, as you can see, already you know. So 9 9s are 81, so remainder will be 0. Next, 36 came down, so next you have to double 9, okay, so 9, double of 9 is what? 18. So here you have to make one place, okay, you have to write another square number. So here I am putting 0. So why I am putting 0? See, as you can see, when we take 36 here, okay, when 36 came down, what will happen if you put 1 8 here? If you put 1, what happens? See, 1 8 1, then you have to multiply it by 1. So 181 into 181 is a 3 digit number, but we are having a 2 digit number. We cannot take 04 to next, because we can only take one number at a time. Already you know, already, okay, so only one pair of number will come down. We cannot take two number at once, okay. So here, why I am not taking 1 or 2 or 3, that is the reason. I am taking 0. So by doing like that, what happened? 18, then I am putting 0. So 180, 180 zeros are, what will happen? 0. So again 36 will come, okay. So now I can take 04 from next, okay. From next we have 04, we can take 04 behind that 36 to get a bigger number, so that we can divide easily, okay. So here our divisor is 180. Next, again you have to double here. See, here we are doubling 9, but here you have to double the ones place, okay, only ones place. Here ones place only we have 9, so we are doubling 9 by double of 9, twice of 9 is 18. So here also we have to double the ones place. In ones place we have 0, and already you know double of 0 is 0 only. So again the number will remain same, okay. So 180 will remain same. Now next ones place you have to leave. So ones place I am taking it 2. Why I am taking it 2? See, our new dividend, our new number is what? 3604. In ones place, the number is what? 4. So you know already, when we multiply 2 with 2, we will get what? 4. So here, that's why I am taking 2. Okay? So 1802 into 2, you will get the number 3604. And the remainder will be what? 0. So what is the square root? We can say the square root of 8136.04 is 90.2. So this is the answer you can do by this way. Also, there is another way of doing it. So how to do it? If you find difficulty, using the decimal point. You can also do one thing, you can simply write, by not writing the decimal, you can write 100 in the denominator. Then after doing the square root of this rational number, okay, so what will happen? The square root of 100 will be what? 10. And this numerator, you can go with the division method for finding the square root. Okay, like this way you can go, because now there is no decimal point here. So you can find the square root of this number. This will be 902 by what? The square root of 100 will be what? 10. So after 902, after getting 902 by 10, we can again place the decimal in correct place. So the final answer will be what? 90.2. You can do this way only. You can do in this way also. But here I have done directly. But you have to show the process how we can get 813604 root of this to 902. You have to show the division process. Okay. So this is the way of doing. So next come to question number 4. So see, question number 4, I have taken 526. You have to find the square root of this. It is written that you have to find it correct up to 2 decimal places. Okay. After point, there should be 2 digits present. So see, I am doing it. 2 2s are 4. 5 minus 4 will be 1. Then 26 came down. So double of 2 is 4. Then in 1's place, I am taking 2. So 42, 2's are will be 84. After subtraction, I am getting 42. So there is no digits behind 526. So what you have to do, you have to put the decimal point. So we will put decimal point. By putting decimal point, we can generate as many zero we want. But here we need in pairs, so we have to take 2 zeros, okay. So 2 zeros we are taking behind 42, okay, 4200. So here again I am taking the double of the 1's place, that is 2, double of 2 into 2, I am writing only. Into 2 it will be what? 4. So here already 4 is there, so it will be 44. So in 1's place I am taking 9. So 449 into 9 is what? 4041. So again by subtraction I got 159. Again we can take double zero, because you have to go up to 2 decimal places. Okay, means after point you have to take two numbers. Okay, so next again by taking the double of 9, it will be what? 18. So 8 carrying 1, 4 plus 1 will be 5. So this is 4. So 4, 5, 8 in 1's place, I have to take 3 to get a number less than 15900. Okay. So like that way, we got what? 93 in the after the decimal point. So the final answer will be what? 22.93.